What's up, guys? This is Red from the YouTube channel Red's Rhetoric, and I'm coming to you from the NonSequitur YouTube channel. This is a response video. So, yeah. Let the shit show begin. A few nights ago, I showed up on the NonSequitur show to talk about the fucked up views of a dude called Emperor Atheist. We will call him EMP from now on. No time to go much into his views, so here's a quick rundown. He doesn't condone homosexuality, you can take that in many fucked up ways. He said some shit that would suggest that being gay means you can't be trusted around kids, and him being a total shithead and doubling down apparently helps his bank account, because that's how that works. The non-sec episode linked below has more details, watch that if you want the nitty gritty. Anyway, a group who shall not be named made a few statements that I want to respond to directly. I will not be linking their channel or the video in question. If you find it on your own, congratulations. What you do at that point is completely up to you. Number 1. Red's Rhetoric called for a boycott of EMP, and who the fuck is he to tell us what to do? I would request that those who made this idiotic statement actually go watch the episode and drop the fucking straw man. At no point did I demand that my followers or subscribers boycott the douchebag in question. What I actually said was that those who are currently subscribed to EMP should at this point ask themselves if they want to remain subscribed to EMP. I told a bunch of my subscribers at the time to support Emperor Atheist, to subscribe to his show and whatnot and whatever. Basically, what I'm doing now is I'm telling all of my subs, and basically if you follow me, if you are indeed a true member of Team Cunt, to go to his channel or his show's channel, whichever. I'm not going to link it. I'm not going to advertise it. But if you know what it is, great. Go there. See if you're subscribed. And if you are, ask yourself this question. Do I really want to stay subscribed to a guy that's this bigoted? In fact, on the non-sex show, I even said that regardless of their choice, I would not hold it against them. I would not think any less of them. See for yourself. I'm not going to say that I'll think less of you if you stay subscribed to that guy, if you continue to support him or whatever. I just ask you to ask yourself, do I want to be associated with this person? Oh shit, I did say that, didn't I? The only action I called for was for people to make a personal choice. How you idiots got boycott out of that is anybody's guess. I don't know if this is a case of people hearing what they want to hear, or just the stupidity and laziness of not actually watching the fucking video before responding to it. But either way, this apparently has caused some people to tell me to go fuck myself. Well, to that I say the following. Anybody who has the ability to get clarification, yet decides to jump the gun anyway, can also go fuck themselves, but twice as hard. Number 2, the non-sex show doesn't give a shit about you or the conversation unless they can make a dollar off of you or the content you are providing. I would like to see you back up that assertion in any way, shape, or form. I don't know if this is a difficult concept to grasp, but you can be genuine in your interest and make money at the exact same time. They are not mutually exclusive, please get your head out of your ass. By that logic, I guess my love for rockets and space is not genuine because I monetize my videos and collect super chats. Fuck the fact that I use those funds to showcase my interest in ways that I couldn't before, and this generates the response I would like people to have when it comes to awesome shit like rockets and space. I live for shit like this. On a similar note, maybe the reason the non-sex show is so successful is because they have the interest and the passion that you say they lack. Maybe they do care that people are being hurt by jilly juice, anti-vax rhetoric, pseudoscientific bullshit, and bigoted views of all shapes and sizes. It's a possibility. And because of that, your assertion is unsubstantiated. You saying shit like this does not mean you're being real with anybody. Being real means being honest, and being honest means labeling your diatribe as your opinion and nothing else. And since I also have one of those, my opinion is that everybody should check out the NonSequitur show and see what wonders await. And finally, number 3, the NonSequitur show is full of hypocrites. They invite shitty people onto the show all the time, and EMP is the straw that broke the camel's back? Wow, what hypocrisy. The difference here is that the dude was actually promoted by the NonSeq show in the past thanks to withheld information by EMP. Kyle has been very clear in the past about his position, his orientation, and the fact that the show will fly the colors of the LGBT. What perfect, multiple opportunities for EMP to be upfront and honest about shit this bad. But because EMP didn't come clean, the NonSeq show actually promoted somebody who is, or was, a closeted bigot. You are correct in saying that the NonSeq show has had fucked up guests. But the difference here is that those shitheads were upfront with their views. He was not. Also, with these other people, no trust was broken, because no trust was there. And by the way, the only reason those who have fucked up views are even invited is to show how badly they fail in making their case for their views and opinions. If they have something compelling, then share it, and it shouldn't be easily torn to shreds live on air. The NonSeq show always accepts that challenge. Exposing bad ideas is a public service in my opinion, and you all should be fucking thankful. The simple fact is this: we do not promote bigots. We expose their bad ideas by having them demonstrate the failure of their position. Because EMP wasn't honest when there was a level of trust there, not only did the NonSeq show unknowingly promote a bigot, but many felt like they were stabbed in the back at the exact same time. Their trust was violated. And on a personal note, anybody who violates my trust can also go fuck themselves. Now, I could go on and respond to more bullshit, but those are the big 3 points that I wanted to address. In closing, I just wanted to inform you all that this video will be monetized. And just because it's monetized, it doesn't mean that I wasn't genuine in calling out this kind of bullshit.